Houston Rockets are expected to re-sign Jeff Green in free agency, which means that they are not planning to rebuild or why bring him back. Russell Westbrook on Instagram this morning posted a video of him wearing a Houston Rockets jersey. I'm sure these guys were able to work it out. Harden and Russ know that their best chance to win is with each other or on a super team such as Brooklyn, which isn't realistic because the Rockets want to keep Harden regardless, and why would they send him to a Nets team for role players, with two of them having expiring contracts? Now, my honest opinion on this is I'm a little bit iffy, right? Because this team, I've never given up on that. And when I say that, well, yeah, I've gone out and said that this team isn't good enough to win, but of course it isn't. They need to go out and get a center or a big man. Christian Wood, Serge Ibaka, Aaron Baines, and that's just the beginning. DeMarcus Cousins, they're going to need two big men. They're going to need Christian Wood, who they better be signing tonight when he hits free agency, because why would we trade Robert Covington for first-round picks if we're not going to bring someone in that is better than him or at least almost as good as him? Now, I do like Rocco. The problem with him, though, is actually, there's really no problem with Rocco. For me to say there's a problem with Rocco would just be idiotic. Honestly, it wasn't a good trade in terms of contending. If we were rebuilding, yeah, two first-round picks for a 29-year-old Robert Covington or 30-year-old Robert Covington, yeah, but Russell Westbrook has no trade value. James Harden has trade value, but no one has really been giving out realistic trades. We saw the Nets and 76ers show interest, but they're not willing to include a Kyrie Irving or include a Ben Simmons, so what would be the point of that? Really nothing. So if James Harden and Russ say they spoke to management, they spoke to Stephen Silas, and they have something that we don't know, because right now it seems like the Rockets don't have enough assets to win, but maybe they have something up their sleeve that we just don't know about. Maybe they have spoke to Christian Wood and he's coming to Houston and nobody knows it yet. Maybe they have Serge Ibaka coming here. Maybe they have DeMarcus Cousins or some other guys, maybe Aaron Baines. Maybe they spoke to them and they have big men coming in. Maybe they have a trade lined up for Eric Gordon. And the thing is, I keep saying maybe because we just don't know. Like, it's hard to make a video on the Houston Rockets right now because nothing is clear. We know that James Harden and Russell Westbrook requested a trade. We know that these guys want out of Houston, but I don't necessarily think that this is unsolvable. Last season, they looked very good. They went into the bubble. They beat the Lakers. They beat the Bucks. They beat the Mavs, all these high-powered teams. And then all of a sudden, they got to the playoffs and nothing worked. And I feel like the reason for that was because Russell Westbrook wasn't healthy. We have to remember that when James Harden and Russ were playing both healthy, they were a very tough team to stop. And it wasn't like they were playing with this great chemistry or they were putting up huge numbers combined. It was mostly just a one-man show. It was Harden goes off or Russ goes off. If Stephen Silas can put these guys together and make them more efficient, make them the best versions of themselves, and bring in another ball handler that can be next to these guys, because right now James Harden and Russell Westbrook are really the only guys in this roster that can create. Of course, there are some guys that they brought in from the draft that I do like, but they're not going to help us win a championship. That is for the future. You don't sign undrafted rookies and plug them right into your starting lineup and give them huge rotation minutes. I mean, Kendrick Nunn was a guy that can come close to that, Duncan Robinson, but at the end of the day, the Houston Rockets are going to need more than a player of that caliber. They're going to need a star next to Harden and Russ. Christian Wood's a good start, but can the Rockets win a championship with just Harden and Russ? That remains to be seen. I feel like they might need a third star there, and we just don't have assets or salary to bring in a third star. Christian Wood, great player. He's not a star, though. I do like his length, his size. He can put the ball on the floor. He reminds me a lot of, honestly, of course, I don't want to compare him to Kevin Durant, but he kind of reminds me of that same skill set. Like, Christian Wood is a very good player. Maybe he breaks out. He already did break out, but maybe he breaks out and has an all-star type season. We're going to need that. It's not looking good because Robert Covington, his defense and versatility, his ability to shoot, he was the second best player on the Rockets in the playoffs, undoubtedly. His defense, he blocked shots. Game 7 was great. He hit timely buckets, which was honestly my favorite thing about his game, was he always hit a timely bucket. Whenever the Rockets needed that three to pull away or a dagger three, it was always Robert Covington hit it. It wasn't Harden or Russ. The thing that I will say is the Rockets could end up trading Harden and keeping Russ. We know that he wants to be the guy on his own team and be the floor general. That probably doesn't happen in Houston. They could move Harden to an off-ball role and let Russ dominate, but that's not winning basketball. To sit up here and say that James Harden playing more off the ball would help us win isn't true. I would get if Russell Westbrook could adjust his game, become a better shooter, become a more efficient player, but at the end of games, Russell Westbrook shrinks. At least James Harden has that IQ to where he makes the right play. Sometimes he just comes up short, like he'll miss a shot or something, but he always makes the right play. How often do you see James Harden make I shouldn't say a silly pass because he does it actually more than he should be, but how often do you see James Harden make the wrong play Usually, if he does come up short, he'll miss a shot or something. He never just turns the ball out of bounds or something. We've seen him dribble the ball off his foot and record his clutch play at moments, but a part of that, I feel like, is just there's so much pressure on Hart. He hasn't had a second consistent option. He's had CP3, Dwight, and Russ, but when have those guys ever been healthy or the best version of himself? Like, Dwight Howard was an abomination. He was never putting in the meta effort. He wanted the ball in the post. Chris Paul was great, especially the first two rounds. Timberwolves and Jazz, Chris Paul was balling out. He's probably playing better than Harden. I mean, not better numbers, but more efficient and was killing it. And then against the Warriors, the first five games, Chris Paul plays well, gets injured. And then the next year after that, Chris Paul was actually just terrible against the Warriors. Like, Chris Paul did not show up. He pretty much choked, and he was healthy. And people say, well, the year before that, you're saying that Chris Paul and the Rockets, if he didn't get that hammy injury, you guys would have won a championship. That wasn't the same Chris Paul. Like, Warriors fans and NBA fans still make that same excuse today. The Rockets were a totally different team. They had more defense. They had Ariza and Bamute who were playing well. They had Chris Paul falling out when healthy. James Harden was the best version of himself. He wasn't dominating the ball. Like, James Harden's usage was still high, but he was averaging 29 a game, not 36 like he did the year after that, or 34 this season. So the Houston Rockets, man, trust me, it's going to be a lot of fun if we keep these guys, just because James Harden and Russell Westbrook are both in their primes, and we all love these guys. They're probably your top two players. Maybe they're elite in your top 10. I don't know, but like, James Harden and Russell Westbrook are very liked players. I'm excited to see them try one more time, but if anything, James Harden, every year we wait to trade him, gets less value because James Harden's on a two-year deal. His contract will expire, and Russell Westbrook, actually keeping him is smart because you're not getting anything for Russ. You're not getting picks or any young players. The best you would get is John Wall, but I think you'd rather have Russ because he's better and we know he's actually going to be ready. Like, John Wall is a question mark. He's a mystery to this point. Even the best version of John Wall is not better than Russell Westbrook. Past few years, I mean, yeah, John Wall's been a good player, but he'll give you 21-9. Russell Westbrook can legit give you 29-8-7, if not more, if he gets higher usage. So I'm okay with it, honestly. Would I like to trade James Harden for a ton of picks and build around this young core that we have of all these undrafted rookies and guys like Chris Clemens and bring back Isaiah Hartenstein? Yeah, it would be a lot of fun. But James Harden, if you can't get anything significant back for him, you have to keep him, pair him with Russell Westbrook, and try one more time. If anything fails, say this team just doesn't have it or looks very bad to start the season, then you can go ahead and try to trade one of them. Maybe James Harden, a team will budge, like maybe the Celtics or a team like the Nuggets, Sixers, maybe they're like, okay, we need James Harden, because James Harden is not going to come out this season and play like a scrub. He's going to get his numbers. He's going to look very good. The only question is, will it translate to winning basketball? And even if it doesn't, it's not entirely on Harden because this team just doesn't have a lot of assets. But let's wait and see, guys. The first step of seeing what the Rockets have planned is where Christian Wood signs. Say if he goes to the Houston Rockets, then we'll know that they traded Robert Covington for two picks and basically Christian Wood, which wouldn't be bad. I know Christian Wood is not Robert Covington, but honestly, they need a Christian Wood more than a Robert Covington. Christian Wood has more length, more size. He's going to get more rebounds. Not that he's the defender or the shooter that Roko is, because he's not even close, but they need a big man. They need a small ball center. Robert Covington is not a center. He's a small forward, power forward. He's more of a stretch forward, very good player, but even trading Roko, as bad as it seems, and it doesn't make any sense, and it never really will, but at the same time, the Rockets needed draft picks, and I know they ended up trading that draft pick for a future pick and to clear salary, which to that extent makes it seem stupid. But yeah, if you traded for that 16th pick and you got a guy that the Rockets could immediately put into the lineup and he could produce, it would have made more sense. But you traded that pick to clear salary. So if Tilman Fertitta doesn't go out and sign someone, or the general manager Rafael Stone doesn't go out and sign someone significant that will be a starter, not a rotation piece, a legit starter that we can plug in over PJ Tucker, over Dan House, then yeah, it makes me feel a lot better. Like, if they bring in Serge Ibaka, then okay, we're talking. But if Tilman Fertitta's plan was just shed salary and just go under the luxury tax threshold and not bring in anyone, I'm going to be very confused if he plans to win a championship without spending that money. The Rockets aren't going to be over, or I guess under the luxury tax threshold and win a championship. It already is hard enough when they were in the luxury tax, yet alone out of it. So yeah, they traded Robert Covington, they cleared cap, and then they ended up trading Trevor Ariza. They did have to pay basically $4.5 million for that pick, which would have been his, I guess, a bonus, if you want to say that. So, I don't know, man. You guys got to let me know your thoughts on the Houston Rockets. Do you think that they have enough on this team to win a championship? Do you think that James Harden and Russell Westbrook is enough? Or do you think they're going to need a third star there? It's your boy Swaggy signing out, guys. Hope you have a great rest of your night. This is my fourth video today. Kind of crazy, honestly. I'm loving it though, man. Hopefully some more Rockets news drops tomorrow, man. Having a lot of fun doing it. It's your boy Swaggy. Peace.